Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Trophinet and welcome back to Bioshock 2 in our Let's Replay series where we try to delve a bit deeper into the lore and the story of the game. We're still at the Atlantic Express, as you can see, ready to board the train towards this area over here, Ryan Amusements. And I think that's actually misspelled, or that might be me. But this is also very interesting, the schedule, because it kind of hints at some other areas we're gonna visit. But I'm gonna leave that in the middle there. But there's still an audio diary over here that we didn't pick up yet. So, the situation.
Sophia Lam has taken Rapture and is responsible for stealing children from the surface. Her splicers destroyed my submersible and forced me to run. But the ticket booth here is secure. And though I cannot trust him, Sinclair is a valuable ally. I have already rescued a few of the new little ones from Lam. They all want to know how we will get home. I wish I had the right words for them.
So right there is another indication of the shift in the story. In the previous Bioshock, we were never really on our way to get out. We didn't really want to get out. That was not the main objective. We wanted revenge on Fontaine. But in this game, this is clearly the goal is more defined. We want to get out with as much little sisters as we can. Kind of the same way we did. We want to help Tenenbaum, of course. Kind of the same way that we eventually did in the original game. But still, it's a kind of a shift in focus. We don't really have a revenge plot ready. We just want to get out. So, with that said, we're gonna head into the train and head towards Ryan Amusements. Here we go. The audio diary was also another indication that Sophia Lam is indeed responsible for the abductions of little girls from the surface.
Whoa there! Now better apply the brakes unless you're aiming to dash yourself against that glacier up ahead.
I do love Sinclair's voice actor. He has a lot of flair about him, just like the dapper gent he is. So, ice in front of us, I think you already know what that will mean.
As you can see, Chief, the station here's iced over. To reach Eleanor Lam at Fontaine headquarters, we'll have to clear the way. Now, in order to melt that ice, you'll need a plasmid like a handful of hellfire. We used to sell a fine old product called Incinerate in the amusement park up yonder. Go on and find a way in. I've already been on all the rides.
There we go. Always found it a bit weird that we couldn't just use our drill to remove the ice, but never mind. We're gonna have to find incinerate in Ryan Amusements ourselves, which is, well, it's kind of double because Sinclair already mentioned that we were heading this way, but now it just kind of looks like we were just passing through on our way to Fontaine Futuristics. Never mind. So we need to find Incinerate. There was something else I wanted to say. But yeah, it'll come to me, I suppose. So this is the booth where we're gonna have to restart the train eventually. I think we can enter. Let's take this Eve hypo. Yeah, this is where we're gonna have to reboot the train once we get the ice removed. So, let's head in. I know again what I wanted to say. Generally, I think I like the level design in Bioshock 2 a bit more. On average, the areas are a lot more interesting than they were in Bioshock 1. Bioshock 1 had some really good levels, like Fort Frolic, but there were a few really bad ones, such as Neptune's Bounty as well. And I think Bioshock 2 generally has the more interesting areas, such as this amusement park. Ryan Amusements, so let's head in. Big staircase. And another one of the family's quotes. We are but the stones to pave the way. There we go. Again, removing the individualism and looking at the people as a whole. I think you already see the team here. Nothing of interest, it seems. Looks like there was somebody living here, though. Just underneath this self-made bed and tent. But, Ryan Amusements, we will be reborn and she is our salvation. Well, You can already guess who she is, of course. We know Sophia Lam has a plan for Eleanor. And yeah, she is our salvation, apparently. More ice with a lot of items in there. I don't think I can't just take the items from the ice. I need to melt it with incinerate. So that will be something for our way out.
So funny. Ain't I enough for you? I'm trying my best.
Ow. Jesus Christ, dude. Okay. You recovered pretty fast from that. No. That actually hurt. Jesus. Huh? Ooh. Laken Scotch. Not gonna drink that. Not gonna start being an alcoholic from the get-go. So let's hack this thing. So now we have red areas. Oh, I missed the blue just by a bit. We're pretty full on everything, so I'm gonna wait with buying anything. I think the hacking is actually better than in the previous game. It's faster, it's easier, doesn't take as long, and I don't think it scales as quickly as it did in the original game, so it doesn't get too hard immediately.
You're a rare old model, son. Alpha series, I believe. Now, Rapture's full of scientific wonderments just like you. And if we can sell them to the world at my price, well, curing your condition ought to be a cakewalk. Once we find Eleanor, the sky's the limit.
So there we have Sinclair's motive. He wants to turn things around and wants to make a buck out of everything that Rapture created, the people of Rapture created. And there we have a very nice, very nice thing. Look at that. So that's the... I think this is really nicely displayed. So over here we have the machine gun from Bioshock 1. And this is already hinting at what we're gonna get in a minute. And this is the machine gun from Bioshock 2. We're gonna just mount that on our arm in a minute. But now we can't reach that because I can't... Although it looks cracked, I can't really break this glass. Weird, I'm a super strong big daddy, but I can't really do that. Another thing that I find a bit sad, the vistas actually look worse in Bioshock 2 because they're just matte paintings and not 3D created cities. But sad, but never mind. And there we have something familiar, as you might remember. The Power to the People station, still from Fontaine Futuristics. Open for business, so let's see which weapon we're going to upgrade first. So this is also a difference. So now we have 3 upgrades per weapon. Also the reason why we come across one already, because there's a lot more in the game than there were in Bioshock 1. Drill fuel efficiency. Cooling nozzles lubricate the drill, reducing the speed of fuel consumption. Or drill damage. Rivet gun damage increase. Or rivet gun clip size. And I think I'm going to go for the gun damage increase. So higher pressure firing mechanism provides greater penetration and damage. There we go. And I think the upgrades look a lot cooler as well. So there we go. Another trophy upgraded the weapon. And now we have those two... that shell on top of the barrel over there. Let's see. Anything around here? Can search desk. We have more rivets. But I didn't increase the clip size, so we can't carry more of those. So I'm just gonna carry around the rivet gun for a bit. So we actually spent some ammo, right? We're going deeper and deeper, and now we're in the manager's office, so it seems another remote hacky thingy for to open the door, but the old sheepdog.
I was hired to engineer a park the likes of which no man has seen. Now all I do is watch over it like a grizzled sheepdog. My first line of mechanical puppets made the children here cool with wonder. But Ryan thought my vision was immature. Antiquated, he said. This place could have been something magical. But instead, he turned it into a school. No, a cathedral. Dedicated to himself.
And there we go. We haven't really entered the amusement park ourselves yet. That's already indicating what Ryan actually has done with the amusement park, what purpose it served. It was a propaganda tool to indoctrinate everybody here to his views.
Hack the door controls. That should pop it open.
Yeah, of course. I know that, Sinclair. Thank you. There we go. Secure door is now unlocked. And let's head back to the rivet gun. And I think, yeah, there we go. Look at that. So there we have our first little sister we can actually do something with, because we can hear another big daddy around as well, hidden from view right now, but we can see the shadow moving away. Goodbye. So we're gonna have to deal with that in a minute. But first, there seems to be something here, a ticket to enter the amusement park, because of course this is a
jam dandy. Okay. That'll get you in the park, but buying incinerate's gonna cost Adam. It's a sort of genetic goo that lets you rewrite whatever God gave you. The little sisters carry the stuff, as you may recall, so you'll need to locate one. I heard whispering near the El Dorado Lounge. Have a look.
So as we get back up, we hear a window shattering, and there we go. A splicer apparently managed to break the glass that we couldn't, so let's pop him in the head with the damage increase that did nicely. And let's take the machine gun. Look at this beauty. The biggest difference with the machine gun from the previous game is that this gun actually is a lot more accurate, even in its standard mode right now. So if we move back to the center,
get yourselves hit. No fuck up this time.
And as you can see, all the bullets hit their targets. Oh, it's arrow to the right, sorry. I've been playing a Bioshock 1 on the highest difficulty since yesterday again. So just to get all the trophies in the game. But so the healing button is at another place. Wow, who made a pretty nice... Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Holy shit. Hardest difficulty. Bam. And there we go. Just taken care of like that. So let's take another look around. Keep going with the rivet gun, because that's our most powerful gun at the moment. And just... Ooh, Dr. Holcroft's cure-all. Thank you very much. I needed that. I'm a bit short of first aid kits right now, but that's not that much of a problem. And yeah, Sinclair is one hell of an exposition machine, isn't he? But I think I like the difference. Instead of just letting the environment speak for itself, we kind of assume that the player knows what's going on, and just let Sinclair do the explaining beforehand. So there we go. We can already see where the tracks lead, because this is actually the attraction here. Journey to the Surface as an on-rails experience. And we're gonna move inside in a minute. I'm just gonna take this with me.
I am Andrew Ryan. Welcome to Ryan Amusements. Please, enjoy the park.
So there we go. We get welcomed inside the park, and this is called the Memorial Museum. So we start out in the museum part of the park. But we get a free sports boost. There we go. In today's dangerous times, it never hurts to be a little faster. Remember, you don't have to outrun the crazed splicer, just your neighbor. There we go. This is also a very big difference in regards to the previous game. Because now we have, I think it's 18 slots in total, without having them separated in categories anymore. So we have 4 slots we can put gene tonics in right now, and we can improve that later on. There we go, sports boost. Now we move a bit faster. Not that it's that big of a difference, but let's take this again with us. But I don't think there are many enemies around here right now. And that's good, because there's some exposition to be had here, because the museum actually explains the origins of Rapture. So let's go.
Andrew Ryan wakes one night while cruising the Atlantic in his steamliner, the Olympian. His sleep interrupted with a singular purpose. Here, he shouts to his crewmen as he wipes sleep from his eyes. Full stop. We begin building here.
There we go. So just indicating that how Andrew Ryan allegedly found the spot to build Rapture.
Refitted for heavy construction, the Olympian returns with a new cargo. A state-of-the-art submersible platform, nicknamed the Sinker, ferries supplies and workers to the seafloor, fathoms below.
There we go, so they made a platform that was used as a base to start building the city. Next up,
After initial supplies have been brought to the seafloor, the platform is permanently moored in the sediment. Massive iron girders are sunk hundreds of feet into the rock and silt. Below the platform, engineers work to overcome obstacles such as diamond-hard rock, obstinate sea life, and unexpected cavalry.
There we go. More exposition, how they anchored the platform and started building. I think we can actually just move on with the rest of them. Just gonna move past here. Are you... Yeah, you're dead, are you? Okay, so then we have this.
After the platform is secured, work progresses at an astounding rate. Designed to be the foundation of Rapture, workers toil around the clock to create the metropolis you see today.
There we go. So there we can see kind of the origins of the Big Daddy suits as well. So the divers that were constructing the city from the bottom up. This one is destroyed, and I think, if I'm not mistaken, there's one over there as well. But we can't just reach that yet. So, what are we going to do first? Because there's a lot of areas around here. We can go to the Hall of the Future. We can go to the gift shop. Or we can head downstairs to the Dorado Launch. Which is, of course, where we have to fight the Big Daddy. Let's see. I think we need Adam first, so I'm just going to pick this up, and then we're going to head towards the lounge.
I love the kids in Ms. Englert's third grade class, but boy, I had no idea what I was getting into, volunteering to chaperone this New Year's sleepover party at Ryan Amusements. Donnie, get down off that exhibit, and I told you, spit out that gum! You'll choke! The kids' parents deserve a night off to enjoy New Year's, but I'm at my wit's end. Donnie! I told you!
So there we go, a volunteer nanny guarding some kids while their parents are spending their evening at the New Year's Eve party. As you well know, a lot of people died at that party, so a lot of those children actually became orphans after this audio diary, sadly enough. So, what's... Oh yeah, so this is the other side of the broken down bit. Don't really need to be here. Maybe check out the box with some vitamins, always handy. Some strength of coffee, giving us a bit more Eve. This is closed off for staff only. So let's go into the Dorado Launch now, shall we? And there we have another gift, apparently. Yeah, so let's watch it.
Until you arrive, Father, I'm trapped here. Smuggling these gifts out is the most I can do to help.
And a nice drawing of a little sister giving a gift to a big daddy. But let's see. Drill power. Prefer your combat up close and personal. With drill power, your drill attacks do more damage. So, same as with Wrench Jockey, this multiplies your damage with the drill. There we go. Thank you, Eleanor. Eat dog.
In ethical psychiatry, we must account for...
Eleanor Lamb speaking. Mum says I'm not to play with the other children because they're being raised on a diet of dog-eat-dog. I wanted to see these dog-eaters. So I waited until Mum was gone and went out to find one. And guess what? The dog-eaters wear human skins. It makes them look just like us.
So, of course, Eleanor hijacked one of her mother's audio diaries. And, she told us that her mother told her that the other kids were being raised on a diet of dog-eat-dog, which just means that they can, of course, compete with each other. And Eleanor took that a bit too literally. Let's see. Rapture. Poseidon Pilsner. Yeah. Okay, then. Thank you for the bullets, Poseidon. And let's move on. Does seem abandoned at first sight. There is a little sister ahead. To get the Atom, you must deal with her big daddy first. He will not attack until you do, but be prepared for a difficult fight. And of course, we don't need the game telling us that. But We do get a bit of tool, so we get the bolt over here, so let's hack this thing, hopefully with the damage boost. There we go. That's one thing that can help us out. We got a bit of water around here as well, so that's a nice starting point.
Now that big daddy won't bite until you do. But to get to Lil Sis, you gotta put the old boy down for good.
So there we go, we kinda have a plan here. We have a few explosive barrels as well. So if we be smart about this, I think we'll put that one over here as well inside of the oil. And then, it is a bouncer, so he's going to attack us head on. Ooh, the little sister's already coming. Boom, 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 boom. And then telekinesis. And explosion. Ooh, that didn't do that much. So he's being attacked by the bolt first. There we go. Just gonna take care of him. Just gonna take care of him. Damn it. So shocking him in the water is a very good tactic here. So luring him into the water every single time. I'm gonna have to be careful though. Just before he strikes, let's just move out of the way. No, no, inside of the water. Yeah, thank you. Ooh, cold. I'm gonna have to be careful here. Ooh. I'm almost out of stuff. Ow. Ow. Ooh, and that was pretty much everything.
Take a breath, son. You did it. Now, just let her ride on your shoulders and she'll trust you like her own daddy.
Come here, little girl. So yeah, one of the bigger differences now is that you actually have the option to adopt a little sister. And she turns around rather quickly. So now we're your the big daddy. There we go. And now she will actually ride on top of our shoulders the entire time.
We're in business. Now, there are corpses all over Rapture, and little Dimples there can sniff out the atom on them. Find one.
And let's take the aspirins. You have adopted a new little sister. Press and hold square to ask her to lead you to an atom-filled corpse. But, another interesting audio diary, Child and Guardian.
I found one of those children at last. Filthy dress, all alone. I approached her, praying that it was my little girl. But she was gorging herself on blood from a corpse. It wasn't her. I stared, just reeling. And then that skinny, armored freak that took Cindy jumped me, shrieking like an animal. I escaped, but could Cindy have become one of those things? I've got to find her, now more than ever.
So there we go, our audio friend Mark Meltzer on his journey to his daughter. Getting into a beef with Big Sister.
We must therefore eradicate tyranny at the genetic level. To end sin itself. That is the family. That is our cause.
So eradicate the genes, which might be a big problem because everybody's genes have been mingled a bit because of Adam. But let's check out the vending machine really quickly. Might stock up on a few Eve hypos and maybe even ammo. I'm not really doing that good on ammo. Yeah, why not? I think I'm gonna just buy one batch of rivets just so we can get out of here. There we go. Ooh, E5.
There will be time to pick Sophia's brain a bit.
Hello. There we go. Don't know what she was doing, trying to hit me probably, but that didn't work out. No, did it. The other thing I really, really like is that Electrobolt isn't draining as much of the Eve as it did before in the previous game, because I think you only could use it twice before you needed to reload, and I think in this game it's 3 or 4 times even. So now we need to gather Adam from a corpse, because we didn't receive any Adam yet, because we didn't rescue or, harvest the little sister yet. So down here is our first corpse, but what I want to do here...
She's got a juicy one, but when she starts draining out the Adam, the splicers will come running. Be ready before you set her down on that body.
So there we go. Sinclair tells us as much. If we set down the little sister, we get a similar effect as we did in the ending of the previous game, where we escorted that little sister. All the splicers will come running. So I'm gonna have to set a few traps. We have a few explosive barrels around here, so that's good. I think I'm gonna hack this thing instead of banging it. And three
just
times.
Just put her right down on that corpse.
Yeah, Sinclair, yeah, I know. But you told me as well that I need to set some traps, so give me some time, please. There we go, some more bullets for my machine gun. And then we're gonna hack this thing as well. There we go, we get another remote hack dart. Let's see what's in here. We do get a bit more trap rivets, which is something I'm gonna use. And then in here... not anything of interest. So, let's see. Let's go for the rivet gun. And set a few That sounds like two separate splicers. I'm gonna switch back to my drill for a second. And take out those guys at least. What? Where did that come from? Ooh, there's one over there.
Hello?
Then that guy has incredible aim. There we go. Okay, so now we're gonna gather a few of the barrels and set that up a bit as well. This is actually one for me as well. Let's take that with me. And that should be enough preparation. So I'm gonna put one right over here. There we go. Let's put it nice and, yeah. I was going to say nice and straight. That didn't really work. And then I'm gonna put a trap rivet right in front of it. Maybe even three. You know what? Why not four? There we go. Then put a few on the other side as well. There we go. And then this one, I think I'm gonna... should I booby trap this one? Maybe I should. Just this wall. And then... yeah, just put a few in here as well. There we go. We can pick those back up if none of them fire. And that should be it. Oh, okay, maybe reload. No. Okay, so that's full. And everything else I can't really use. So that's... start off with the normal rivet gun and then swap when we need to. So let's gather Adam. Here you go, little girl. Have fun.
That is a child of the family. Not a toy for you to exploit and discard. It is fitting that you expire here. One more forgotten curio in Ryan's shrine to the self.
Here they come. Keep the splicers off her now till she's finished, or they'll never give up the hunt.
There goes one. If I can shoot them, all the better. Okay, that one jumped down and jumped on top of the trap rivet. Oh, there we go again.
Come on.
And there are a lot of them. If you, And the last few guys we're gonna have to take care of ourselves. Ah, he just got a hit in, didn't he? There's going to be a few over there, but if we take a telekinesis and just smack that, okay. Oh, wait. There we go. Let's pop his counter attack. There we go. And let's whack you in the face as well. There we go. Whew, that actually went pretty well. Didn't only need
Daddy,
to heal
are
once.
Are you taking me home too?
Yes, I'm gonna take you home eventually.
Now you know the stakes, son. But a plasmid costs a bit more atom yet. Keep it up.
So there we go, indicating that we need to find another corpse, even though that just drained most of our resources. I don't think, yeah. All of the trap rivets have gone off, and my experiments actually went a bit bad, because this thing didn't explode because of the rivet hitting it. No biggie, no biggie. This is actually mine, right? So let's just heal at that thingy. And let's hack the vending machine to get me another Eve hypo. Ooh, look at that. Well, you know what? A few. And let's get me some rivets as well. Because I really like the rivet gun now that it's upgraded. So one little sister done. And I am going to take a little break before we head into the amusement park proper. But wait. I think there is a hidden trophy around here. Yeah, there we go. If you remember, this is a statue of Andrew Ryan. You might remember how we killed Andrew Ryan in the previous game. There is a trophy to do it again. So here we have the same golf club that we used to kill him in the original game. And if we just use telekinesis to put that in his head, there we go. We get the 9 irony trophy just to... Well, the irony that we killed him the same way we did in the previous game, with a golf club to the face. There we go. I'm actually gonna play this as well from the desk of Andrew Ryan.
Why, hello there. My name is Andrew Ryan. I built the city of Rapture for children just like you, because the world above had become unfit for us. But here, beneath the ocean, it is natural to wonder if the danger has passed. If those we left behind will ever come to their senses. So, let us imagine, you and I, what might befall us on the surface.
Okay, there we go. So, indicating that the next attraction is actually a big warning to not go back to the surface. But, with the words of Andrew Ryan, we're gonna take a little break. So, thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really, really appreciate the support. Thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye!